doodle doot doodle doodle loot. Alright, we're gonna read it again. We're just gonna keep reading it until things start soaking in so that we can start deciphering everything, all the details. Let's start chapter 2 this time. My brethren, hold not in respect of persons the faith of the glory of the Lord Yeshua the Anointed. If there may come into your synagogue, a man with a gold ring and gay raiment, and there may come in also a poor man in vile raiment, and you may look upon him bearing the gay raiment, and may say to him, "You, sit you here well," and to the poor man may say, "You, stand you there, or sit here under my footy stool." You did not judge fully in yourselves, and to become ill-reasoning judges. Listen, my beloved brethren, did not the Most High choose the poor of this world, rich in faith, and heirs of the reign that he promised to those loving him? And you did dishonor the poor one. Do not the rich oppress you, and themselves draw you to judgment seats? Do they not themselves speak evil of the good name that was called upon you? If indeed you complete the royal law, according to the writing, you shall love your neighbor as yourself, you do well. And if you accept persons, you do work sin, being convicted by the law as transgressors. For whoever shall keep the whole law and shall stumble on one point, he has become guilty of all. For he who is saying, "You may not commit adultery," said also, "You may not do no murder." And if you shall not commit adultery and shall commit murder, you have become a transgressor of the law. So you speak and so do, as about to be judged by a law of liberty. For the judgment without kindness is to him not having done kindness. And exult does kindness over judgment. What is the profit, my brethren, if faith anyone may speak of having, and he may not have works? Is that faith able to save him? And if a brother and a sister be naked, and may be destitute of daily food? And if any one of you may say to them, "Depart in peace, be warm and filled," and may not give to them the things needful of the body, what is the profit? So also the faith, if it may not have works, is dead by itself. But say, "You have faith and I have works. Show me your faith out of your works, and I'll show you out of my works my faith." You do believe that the Most High is one, you do well. And the demons believe, and they shudder. And do you wish to know, O vain man, that the faith apart from the works is dead? Abraham our father was not he declared righteous out of works, having brought up Isaac his son upon the altar? Do you see that faith was working with his works, and out of the works the faith was perfected? And fulfilled was the writing that is saying, And Abraham did believe the Most High, and it was reckoned to him to righteousness, and he was called friend of the Most High. You see, then, that out of works is man declared righteous, and not out of faith only. And in like manner also Rahab the harlot, was she not declared righteous out of works, having received the messengers, and by having sent forth another way? For as the body apart from the spirit is dead, the spirit is dead, so also the faith apart from the works is dead.
Precise!
Let's read chapter 1. James, of the Most High, of the Lord Yeshua the Anointed, a servant to the 12 tribes who are in the dispersion. Hail! Count it all joy, my brethren, when you may fall into various temptations, knowing that the proof of your faith does work endurance. And let endurance have a perfect work, that you may be perfect and entire, lacking in nothing. If any of you do lack wisdom, let him ask from the Most High, who is giving to all liberty and not reproaching, and it shall be given to him. And let him ask in faith, doubting nothing. For he who is doubting has been like a wave of the sea, driven by wind and tossed. For let that man not suppose that he shall receive anything from the Lord. A two-souled man is unstable in all his ways. And let the brother who is in low rejoice in his exaltation. And let the brother who is in low rejoice in his exaltation. And the rich in his becoming low. Because he shall pass away as the flower of the grass. For the sun did rise up with the burning heat, and did wither the grass, and the flower of it fell. And the grace of its appearance did perish. So also the rich in his way shall fade away. Happy the man who does endure temptation, because, becoming approved, he shall receive the crown of the life that the Lord did promise to those loving him. Let no one say, being tempted, I am tempted from the Most High. For the Most High is not tempted of evil, and himself does tempt no one. And each one is tempted, being led astray and enticed by his own desires. Afterward, the desire, having conceived, does give birth to sin. And the sin, having been perfected, does bring forth death. Be not led astray, my beloved brethren. Every good giving and every good perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow of turning. Having counseled, he did produce us with a word of truth, and are being a certain first fruits of his creatures. So then, my beloved brethren, let every man be swift to hear, slow to speak, and slow to anger. For the wrath of man does not work the righteousness of the Most High. For what reason, having put aside all filthiness and superabundance of evil, be receiving the engrafted word in meekness that is able to save your soul, and become you doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving yourselves? Because if anyone is a hearer of the word and not a doer, this one has been like to a man viewing his natural face in a mirror. For he did view himself and has gone away, and immediately he did forget of what kind he was. And he who did look into the perfect law, that of liberty, and did continue there, this one, not becoming a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the work, this one shall be happy in his doing. If anyone does think to be religious among you, not bridling his tongue, but deceiving his own heart, of this one the religion is.
Careful, bud.
Pure religion and undefiled with the Most High and Father is this: to look after orphans and widows in their tribulation, to keep himself unspotted from the world. Alright, so now upon reading that, now we're going to have to decipher it. And we're going to have to figure out that James is talking to his Israelite brethren that they're committing the sin. So we need to take each little word, each little phrase, each little sentence, each little idea, and we need to make it bow down to the truth.
Yeah, don't make it bow down, man. It's gonna bow down, alright. Yeah, we're gonna make it bow down. Boing!
Alright, so we're gonna take all these words, we're gonna decipher them, and we're gonna make them bow down to the truth. We're gonna make them agree with all the rest of the truth of the sin, all the rest of the scriptures.
Ha! Yeah!
So we're at 12 minutes, so we have a few minutes here. One of the things that came to mind right off the bat that was easy to decipher was, he says here, be a doer of the work. Not a forgetful hearer, but a doer. Now, we know from our studies of verse 14 through 18 in chapter 2 that a doer of the work is one who speaks the truth. Faith without works, the faith without the works is dead. What's the works that are performed? Speaking the truth out of our mouth. So here he says, be not a forgetful hearer, but a doer of the word. So now we hear we have a decipher to decipher what that little phrase is, how that phrase is defined. It's defined as homologeo. That word is to speak the same as another. To speak the truth about the sin. To speak the truth about Yeshua, how he spoke about the sin. So, where's that at? Okay, so that's chapter 1, verse 25. Be a doer of the work. All right. So we're going to underline that and make us a spark plug wire. Doer of the work equals speak the truth to our brother Homo Lo Gayo. A doer of the work equals speak the truth to our brother Homo Lo Gayo.
They had to speak the truth. after our brother home again.